Starting in machine embroidery can be a bit of a daunting and confusing task. You might be wondering, where do I start? What all do I need to know? And how can I learn it all quickly? Well, thankfully, our new Easy to Follow Embroidery Legacy Beginner Series is going to answer all these questions and more for you. To help you get past the learning curve and well on your way to mastering this beautiful art. Hi, I'm John Deere, the world's most awarded embroidery digitizer and owner of Embroidery Legacy. My family's been in the embroidery industry since the 1950s, and with over 35 years of experience under my belt, I've taught thousands of new embroiderers like you the ropes. In these embroidery beginners videos, I'm going to walk you through some of the essential embroidery principles and share some of our family's time-tested tips, tricks, and secrets, from hooping to thread types and so much more. If you follow along with these videos, you'll be embroidering like a pro in no time. In our last video, we covered thread, and in this video, we're going to cover stabilizers. And yes, there is a stabilizer stash. You can never have too many because they'll always come in handy. Now, here's the thing. I personally will shop for my stabilizers based on price point as opposed to who they're made by, because to be honest, all stabilizers are made by a couple of main manufacturers, and then they're white labeled and made into these tiny little rolls and sold through various vendors. So if somebody ever says to you, I have the best no-show mesh that's made on the market, I'm not necessarily saying they're lying, but they might have been misinformed, because most of the no-show mesh comes from one or two plants and then gets distributed to everybody. So the quality is basically the same. I look for a product that has a great price point and the same quality, and usually I find that online because you're not dealing through a middleman. If you want to support your local dealer, I totally respect that, because we should support the companies that are supporting us with regards to education, but with stabilizers, generally the price will kind of dictate where I personally will look to buy it. Now, there are some main stabilizers that you will always use over and over again, and we'll narrow them down to two of them, which is a tearaway stabilizer. And a tearaway does exactly what it says. It tears away very easily. You can purchase it in different weights or thicknesses. And I'll have this on hand because if I'm doing key fobs or some in the hoop projects, or if I'm just putting and floating materials and tearing them off afterwards, it's a very quick, easy process. Besides the tearaways, there is another brand of tearaway which I particularly like, and it's one that's called Tearaway Wash Away. It is a tearaway stabilizer, but it does, when you tear it away, have the little fluffies left on the edge, and as you put it through a regular laundering cycle, those exposed areas will disintegrate and you won't see anything on the inside. So if I'm doing something like a blade and I know I'm not going to button it up all the time and it's going to fly open, I don't want to see a cutaway stabilizer on the inside. I just want to see the stitches, and I don't want to see any remnants of this either. If I'm doing bedding sets, I'll also use that tearaway wash away because they'll, you know, become soft, and I won't necessarily feel the underside of a thick stabilizer that's scratching on my skin. So there's different variances of that as well. Now, as far as regular cutaways are concerned, you can buy it in large or small, different weights. Cutaways generally do what they say. You have to physically cut around them to get rid of the stabilizer because they are very, very strong. And you can get different weights. Now, cutaways are good, but if it's too thick and if you're using it on a wearable item, sometimes you can see a stabilizer shadow. And what I mean by that is you can literally see the outline of where the stabilizer's been cut. And to me, that really doesn't look as professional as I would like. But they are the two basics, and yes, you should have them for certain projects. Now, I will cover my favorite cutaway stabilizer. This one is a product that is called no-show mesh. No-show mesh is a little bit unique because when you look at it closely, it has a heat press grid that kind of goes in X and Y's, and that is what makes it so strong in both directions. It is very, very sheer and lightweight. If I hold this product up and literally look through it, I could see outlines of people, and, you know, I'm not seeing their faces, but it's that sheer, and that makes it incredibly strong, but also incredibly soft. So it's that grid that really reinforces it. Now, it is actually made in three different flavors. We have chocolate, we have vanilla, and we have strawberry, and you need all three. If I'm going to do dark items, I will want the black. If I'm going to do light items, I'm going to use the white. And if I'm going to do or embroider sheer white items, I'll probably use the beige because it matches most people's flesh tones and you won't see the stabilizer shadow underneath. So this is my go-to. I use this one probably more than any other stabilizer as a whole is the no-show mesh. Now it also does come in the three flavors, but it also comes in a fusible. This is non-fusible, and I can tell because the front of the stabilizer looks the same as the back. With this one, it is a no-show mesh, but the front is kind of dull and matted, but the other side is shiny. And that is because there is a fusible powdered adhesive that is on there, and you always will take the shiny side, and you can iron it onto items. If you are a quilter and you see puckering happening in your fabrics as you're doing your quilt squares, if you iron this material onto it, this stabilizer onto the material, you'll basically adhere the fabric to the stabilizer. There'll be no slipping in between, and you'll get much, much better results. I'll use this on t-shirts, on sweatshirts, on anything with a stretch, anything that is sheer or slippery, I might actually try to put this on. If I'm doing appliques, I will many times back my applique materials with this stabilizer because it reduces the fraying of the actual material and gives me a little bit more substance to my applique, and the appliques generally come out cleaner as well. So again, this is your go-tos. We have no-show mesh, three different shades, and fusible in three different shades, and yes, you should have them all. Now, another stabilizer that I would highly recommend that you have is one that is called a wet-and-gone stabilizer. It looks like a regular stabilizer, but if I were to pour water on this, it would literally dissolve away. It dissolves away with water. It dissolves away better with hot water. And all of our in the hoop projects, things that we have on our site that create, eye masks, or we're making key fobs, to be honest, or if I'm doing, let's say, bookmarks, or I'm making ornaments, or I'm doing 3D, or especially doing freestanding lace, this is the actual material that I use. Now, keep in mind, we do have YouTube videos specifically for this product and the no-show mesh on our YouTube channel. So if you want more information on how to hoop this, how to secure it, and how to use it properly, you can go there and check those out. Now, this one actually does come in a single weight for the most part. A lot of people will say that if you double it up, it's better. I gotta be honest, and this is my personal opinion, any design that's digitized properly should only ever need one layer of stabilizer. I don't care whether it's a jacket back design, a left chest design, whether it has 10,000 stitches or 200,000 stitches, if it's done correctly, you should only need one layer. And that goes for our freestanding lace. We have designs that were done for the bridal industry that have over 100,000 stitches in them and will still only use one piece of this wet and gone stabilizer. And the reason why is our lace was made for the bridal industry, which is, nice, sheer, soft lace. It's not meant to be a doily or a bowl, and it's not overly stitch intensive. Now, there are ways to secure it properly, and we do cover that in our videos as well. Now, there is other types of brands of this. One is where you actually have the wet and gone, but it does have a paper backing on it, and what you do is you peel away one side, and this product stays tacky, which is wonderful if you're doing things like cutwork napkins, or you're doing placements where you need a little bit of tackiness, because you can't use a spray adhesive on this product. It will melt the stabilizer away. So there is other products that are made specifically for getting that tacky effect and doing specialty projects. So that is another stabilizer that is one of our go-tos and our musts. We're going to talk about toppings for a second because the stabilizer on the back is important, but if you are dealing with any materials like PK knits, any milled materials that have a lot of stretch going one direction, they have those hills and valleys, or I'm talking about t-shirt material, sweatshirt material, or anything with a high pile like terry cloth or serpa fleece where things can easily sink into the material, then you need to have a topping. And the topping that I have here is a water-soluble topping. This topping essentially gets floated on top of the item that you've hooped. I personally don't like to hoop this in with the other two pieces because then it becomes almost like a blurry window pane. You can't tell if your material is pulled tauntly enough and if there's no, you know, ripples in it. So I do like to have this floated on top and I'll tack it in place with either a little bit of water or a pin. But when you put this on top, it really ensures that those top finishing stitches stay nice and clean. It actually adds a little bit more density to your thread, so to speak, and gives cleaner, crisper lines. You don't have things sinking into terry cloth or fleece as much. The only trick that I have for this is when you tear it away, you'll take all of your waste. It tears away very easily. You'll take all of this waste and you'll take a tennis ball. Now, if you're kind of wondering what I'm referring to, you got to go to our YouTube channel and watch our tennis ball and our Solvi ball and how you get rid of Solvi, because the way to get rid of this product on the open areas of the O's and the A's or on any part of the design is to use the same material. It attracts like a magnet. So we have little tips for that as well. Now, one last stabilizer that I'm going to talk about, this is actually called a heat and gone. It is a topping, but it is a heat and gone stabilizer. And you can tell which is the side that goes down because it almost is a little bit dimply on one side and smooth on the other. You put the dimply side down on the fabric, so hopefully it won't move as much. You embroider the design. Because this is a heat and gone stabilizer, not a water soluble stabilizer, all of this will remain underneath of the stitches. And the only way to get rid of it is with the direct heat of an iron. Even in the dryer on the hottest cycle, it won't remove the stabilizer. And this is one of the best stabilizers I've ever found for doing terry cloth. I'm talking about those towels that you actually have as a decorative display in your, you know, guest bathrooms. The ones that I'm not allowed to use because they're meant for special people and not people like me. Those are my wife's rules. But usually people will throw away those towels, not because the towel is starting to look, you know, used and worn. It's because the embroidery is starting to get a little bit worn out and all of those long satin stitches that you like to use on terry cloth get a little bit loopy. With this stabilizer, it holds those stitches firmly in place because this never disappears, even in a laundering and a drying cycle. And when you hit this with the heat from an iron, and make sure you read the directions. And when I say read the directions, this is where you always keep your directions for whatever stabilizer you have in your stash inside. Otherwise, you'll forget what it is and you won't know. So always keep it with you. But read the directions, because with the exact heat settings that it specifies, this product actually evaporates with heat. It melts and evaporates. It doesn't gum up your irons. It literally kind of goes away. It's like embroidery magic. So those are a few of my favorite things with regards to stabilizers, and you're going to want to, you know, stay tuned for the next video where we'll cover another great topic. Thanks for watching. If you want to make your embroidery life easier, be sure to hit the subscribe button below to be notified of new tips and tricks videos, giveaways, and more. Plus, if you want to try stitching out some of our embroidery designs, click the link in the description below to learn how to download your free Embroidery Legacy design kit today.